Hi guys and welcome back to my channel. Last week I showed you how to start powering up your Instagram profile by creating a beautiful branded custom Linktree background in Canva. So since you asked, this week I'm going to show you how to add multiple clickable links to that Linktree background and customize them using some exciting tools. I'll also be showing you how to connect your social media platforms with LinkedIn, as well as a MailChimp email list to help you get more leads. And finally, we're going to be connecting Linktree with WhatsApp. So if you're ready to make a start, let's pop over to Linktree. Last week I showed you how to set up your account on Linktree and then create a beautiful custom Linktree background. If you missed the tutorial, make sure you check it out. I'll leave a link in the end screen and in the description box below. To start adding clickable buttons to your background, you'll first need to go over to your Linktree dashboard. Go to the top left-hand corner of your screen and click on the Appearance tab. You've already set up your profile. We covered this in last week's tutorial. So scroll right down until you find the Buttons section. You can now choose from a selection of filled buttons, buttons with just an outline, buttons with shadows, a soft shadow, and so on. Personally, I like to keep things simple, so I'm going to select this pill-shaped button. Customize the button color by scrolling down until you find the button color heading. You can paste a specific color hex code into this box here, such as one of your brand colors. Alternatively, click your cursor inside this box, hold this little tiny button down with your cursor, and move it around the box. You can also grab hold of this slider bar and move it up and down the bar here until you find the colour you want. I'm going to stick with something really simple, so I'm going to make my button colour white. You'll be able to see how your buttons start taking shape by checking the smartphone mock-up on the right-hand side of your screen. Underneath the buttons section, you'll find the fonts. By selecting one of these fonts, it will change the font not only on the buttons, but also on your Linktree background. Happily, I've got one of my brand fonts here, so I've selected that. Once you've done that, scroll up again until you find the background section. And you want to click on the background color because that is going to be the color of the text on your buttons. So I'm going to be terribly boring. I'm going to make the text black by just pulling that button down like that. Fabulous. Now you've done this once, you don't have to keep going through this process for each new button you create. Now let's start adding your links. Go to the top of your screen again, to the top left-hand corner, and click on the Links tab. For the sake of this tutorial, I've already gone ahead and added a mock link. So to add a new link, all you need to do is, surprise, surprise, click on this purple button to add a new link. And this is where you will customize your new link. First of all, add a link title. Try and keep it concise, so try and stick to just two or three words. Underneath, click on the little pencil and add the corresponding link to this box. Now, because this is a link to my YouTube video, I'm prompted to make some further choices in this section here. You won't see this if you link out to a blog post. Underneath this link section, you'll find seven little icons, and these are all your link tools. Use the first one if you're linking out to a YouTube video. The second link is what's called a leap link, and for a short period of time, this will send all your visitors directly to this link. Now think carefully when you use this. Generally, I use it for the first day when posting a new blog or a video, since I want to drive more traffic to it. To enable a leap link, click on the purple button, and you're prompted to set an end time. The default setting is 24 hours, which for me is absolutely plenty. Click on the next little icon to set up a thumbnail image. You have two options. You can upload your own custom thumbnail from your own device, such as your laptop, from Facebook, Instagram or Google Drive. Or you can choose one of these little icons from Tabler icons. I'm going to upload the thumbnail image I created for my last tutorial. If you're creating in Canva and you're wondering what size thumbnail image is best, you can stick to a regular square template, which is 800 by 800 pixels. Once uploaded, you can crop the image by holding your cursor down over one of these corner buttons and dragging it into place. When you're happy, click on Save and then Upload. And if I look on the right-hand side at my smartphone mock-up, I can see that my thumbnail image has been applied. The next little icon is to set a priority link. Use this to draw your audience's attention to a specific link. So it might be your latest blog post or video or podcast even. So just hold your cursor over one of the little animations and see how it works. I think I'm going to choose Wobble. And you can see how that works by checking on the smartphone image on the right-hand side of your screen. The next icon is the schedule icon. And as you can see, you cannot use it at the same time as a leap link. So I'm going to disable the leap link. Click your cursor in the spaces provided to select your start date and time and your end date and time. The schedule link is particularly useful if you want a link to appear on your menu for a specific period of time. So you'd use this if you want to get people to sign up for a webinar that's happening on a specific date. And you can see when you've set it up, the icon turns orange because you scheduled it ahead of time. Next is the lock icon. And I honestly can't imagine you'd use this very often. So I'm going to close that down and click on the final little tool, which is your link analytics. And since I've just set this account up for the purpose of this tutorial, I can't show you any analytics yet. But if I pop over to my own Linktree account, these are my links here. If I click on the analytics button for my latest YouTube tutorial, it will give me some pretty handy information. So over the last day or so, I've had 3 clicks on this particular button. My biggest audience is in the UK. Thank you, guys. And my audience is viewing my content via their smartphone device. So analytics gives you a really handy insight to how your links are doing. Next, we're going to link up with your social media platforms and also an email list. First of all, we're going to go to the top left-hand corner of the screen and click on the Settings tab. From the left-hand menu, you're going to go right down until you find Social Links and click on that. First of all, you want to decide whether you want these links to appear at the top or the bottom of your screen. And I think I'm going to add mine to the bottom. The first link to add will be your email address if you want. Now go ahead and copy and paste links to your social media platforms. I would choose your top 3 best performing platforms. Otherwise, it's going to look really cluttered. And this is what my settings look like. You can see as I hover my mouse over the smartphone mock-up that each one is clickable. And I think the buttons look quite neat at the bottom, don't you? And now for one of my Nicky Ninja tips. You can set up email list integrations. I'm not going to do that because I'm going to show you a quick workaround. I'm going to add a new link. From the Links tab, I'm going to click on Add New Link. I'm going to create a title. And underneath, I'm going to copy and paste a link from my MailChimp email list into this box right here. And there is my new link, which if I click on it, will take me directly to my MailChimp sign-up form. For those of you who want to connect a Linktree with your WhatsApp account, go to the Settings tab again, go to Social Links, scroll down until you find WhatsApp and click on it. Now here you're prompted to add your phone number. And this for me is a bit of a problem because I don't like to have my phone number visible to all and sundry. So again, here's a Nicky Ninja tip for you. So rather than connect using your phone number, consider adding a link to a specific chat group. From your WhatsApp group, scroll down and find invite via link. Copy the link, go back into Linktree and create a new link, and paste that link into the URL space. Add a thumbnail, and now people can safely connect with you on WhatsApp. And this is actually my own bridesmaid WhatsApp group. And that is all there is to creating your own clickable links in Linktree. Thank you so much for watching. As always, coming up next, if you missed last week's tutorial, you will find the link just here. And if you're a Canva fan, why not dive into my extensive playlist of Canva tips and tricks? And that's coming up right here. Thanks again, and I will see you next time.